What was it you were looking for again? I'll be with. Excuse me just a moment. I'll be with you in just a moment. Got another customer. Don't you move now. Is this what you had in mind? This is one of a kind. I got this from a particular fella. Says, need to find a home. What kind of doctor are you again? A plague doctor. Oh, a plague doctor. And this is what they wear. Interesting. Well, want to take a look at it? Here you go. I'll be with you in just a moment. I recognize you from before. Yeah, you look a little different this time. What was that? I'm asking 5,000 credits. That's too much. Part with it if the offer was right. Okay, sure thing. Here you go, and I'll take that money from you. Now, wait a minute. What kind of fool do you take Chris Crinkle for? This ain't real money. It don't smell like real money. It don't feel like real money, neither. It is, special kind of money. What special kind of money is this? Really now? Can I buy the Dagobah system? Really? How about the Tatooine Dune Sea? I can. Well then, consider yourself a valued customer. Go along with that mask now. If you have any problems, here you go. Okay. If you have any problems with that, sorry about that. It's kind of close quarters in here. You just come on back, and I'll see what I can do. It was a pleasure meeting you, Dr. Clemmons. Now, you associated with Professor Clemmons. You'd rather not say him. I respect that. Take care now. Now, I do apologize about that. What can I do you for? Are you interested in... triggers? Are you looking for... tingles? Well, you've come to the right place. My name's Chris Crinkle, and this is my House of Tingles. Now, I can see you've got a little something peculiar going on right here. It's quite interesting. You mind if I... okay. How did you come about to be in this particular predicament? You don't know. Something I can do for you. Is there anything in particular that you're looking for? My shirt? Well, thank you. What's that stand for? You don't know. Well, I am an esteemed member of the Cool Kids Club. Our motto is be cool. Are you a member? Well, they've grown exponentially in numbers. But enough about them. What can good old Chris do for you? You like to browse? Okay. Let's see what I have for you. I got this particular item. Have you ever seen one of these before? It's got a nice relaxing sound. I like to call it crushing tapper. You can put all kinds of what's-its in here, and who-diddies, and thinkamadaddies. Crush them up, and relax. Listen to this. This is a one-of-a-kind. You ain't gonna find tingles like this anywhere. I happen to pick this up. Just a moment. How's that? Is that better for you? There you go. Oh, not a problem, not a problem. Listen to them sounds. There was a particular fella that come around here with this object. Some kind of shaman, some kind of healer, wanted to know if I'd be willing to trade. obliged. And I traded for him. Should I put that down for you on the order form? Okay. One. One. Tingle. Masher. Tapper, crusher. What's that? What's this? This is something special. This is not for sale. This is my totem. No, it don't ward off evil spirits. What this does is helps me write things down on paper. It's called my totem. What do you think about that? I made it myself. He's ready to spring into action. I got that masher down for you. Now, speaking about the life expectancy of beluga whales, I thought I would show you my pets. There you go. Ain't they the cutest things? What? He ain't looking too well. I wonder what happened to him. Now, Jeffrey. He look a little tired, but he seemed okay. I poked holes in the top of the lid. So they have plenty of air to breathe. And I fed them some peanuts and some green beans and some chips. That's what I found on the internet telling me to feed them those things. You ever had marshmallow pets before? No, not like these. Well, I'm not sure what I did wrong, but Jeff. Jeffrey seems okay. You all right in there, Jeffrey?
Yeah, I'm okay.
You hear that? He's all right. Maybe he's just a little sad that Thomas is dead. I wouldn't blame him. Well, at least I have one pet left. Did you ever go hunting for marshmallows? It's a tricky job. It's a very tricky job. You gotta have stealth like a camel. And the sights. Now, you'll excuse me a moment, I am particularly parched. Speaking about the distance between two points, let me show you my next set of tingles. This might be something that you like, or it might be something that you like very much, or it could be something that you don't even like all too often when you're not liking it a lot. Got me some matches. Think about that. It's kind of nice. Let me get another one out here. That one kind of burned out quickly. Now, let's try that again. One more time. Maybe you kind of like the sound of this. Matchstick tingles. One of a kind. Do you know how long it took me to master these triggers? Well, it's a secret. To master those triggers, I had to walk in the park backwards while whistling Dixie 17,000 times. Only on Tuesdays, not including holidays. Let's see if you like these triggers, these tingles over here. Better for you. Now, listen to those triggers. What do you think about those? Kind of relaxing. Got a nice little clickety sound. Clickety, clickety. Try the other ear now. Here we go. You like those? Just that little gentle clicking sound of going through matches in a matchbox stick. Matchbox sticks. I want them to be lighting now. And just relaxing with them. You just relax. Let's try this again. I'm gonna try to get you nice and relaxed. You don't have to worry about this predicament that you find yourself in. Let's try this again. Just give it a moment. Give it just a moment. I blew it out again. I'm just not having that much luck. But maybe that sound is nice for you. Take your worries away, far away, where they can't chase you and take you back from where you were, strapped up and down to a chair, performing their experiments on you. Should I put you down for those particular triggers? Okay. You're gonna think you wanted those. Alright. Okay. Let's see what else I've got for you. Just a minute again. I'm still a little particularly parched. Careful of drinking. Suit yourself. Yeah. see what Chris got for you. Here's a little something special. These are one of a kind. You ain't gonna find these triggers nowhere else. That's right. These are what I like to call rainy day triggers. See if you like the sound of these. Sound myself. Let's try that again. Took me to master these triggers. It took me solving the world's hunger crisis. But unfortunately, find that tingle-rific. Are these the tingles you were looking for? You mind if I ask you how you came to be in this peculiar predicament. You don't know. Does anyone else know about this? Professor Clemmons. I don't know if you should have visited him. Tinfoil Hat Society man. He's a good man, though he's little. Crazy. Yeah, he's my twin brother. Yes, he is. I'm the older brother. We were both. Well, let me tell you a secret. Subjects of Professor Clemmons. That's right. But the professor did help us get this far. Would you like me to put you down for a pair of these rubber glove tingles? Very well. You also happen to see the green man. He's another one of the professor's experiments. Gone horribly wrong. Horribly. No one knows who the green man was before he turned green. Some say if you walk around the streets at night when it's dark, because at night it's dark, it's not daylight during the day because it's night, you gotta be careful that you don't trip over something because it's dark and it's hard to see. Now, I got something special for you. Two somethings. That's right. Now, these next particular tingles are quite unique. Now, particular set of triggers would you be interested right now? These bolts and springs. Or these nuts. The bolts and springs. With a jar of nuts. Good choice. Now, we're gonna start with some tippity tap. See if you like tippity tap. You like them sounds? Tappy tippy tap. How about a little scraping? Put that right up to your ear. And see how you like that. You like that? And we just turn it. Just gentle like. Because they make it clickety-clack a sound that can be a little too much for the ears to handle. Now we're gonna go over to this ear. We're gonna tippy-tap. Like that tippy-tap sound. Scrapey-scrapes. Pleasing sound, ain't it? Relaxing like, kinda like when you're eating, or maybe like when you're playing one of them video games. Now, we're gonna reach inside this jar and just play. Play with them. Listen for them clickety clacky sounds. Clickety clack. Just like that. You wanna hear that up close again? Let's go over to the other side. See how you like that? not to be too clickety-clacky, because it can be... But we want it to be relaxing for you, without a doubt, without a doubt. Passing through here not too long ago. This jar. Wanna know. If I would be willing to trade. I said, I'm sure I would. So he offered me this jar of nuts. And in return, I offered him my own jar. Peanuts. And you might come across him. And if you do, you ask him how he likes that jar of nuts. Now, would you care for this jar? Care for a sampling? I can give you as many nuts as you like out of this jar. 1, 3, 17, 20, 24. Maybe you would like 30 of them. Would you like 35 of them? If you want 35, I can give you 36. We can give you 3 more. I can give you maybe 50. Would you like 50? Maybe you only want 12. Well, if you want 12, and maybe I throw in an extra 7, maybe you come back, and maybe you want 29 of them. Maybe you want to think about having 70 of them. Maybe you only want 4, and come back later for 7, and then have 12 right now, after you only look at 8, and then decide which of the 13 of the 9 that you want. Does that sound good? Okay. I'll put you down for those. How many did you want again? Okay. Give you a few samples right now if you like. And you can always come back for the rest. Drooping there a little bit. Let me help you out. There you go. See. I ain't quite ever seen a plastic bag like this before. there's somebody. Somebody that might be able to help take that off of you. I don't have those kind of skills. It's going to require some kind of surgical magic. Now, speaking of the dried husks of an ancient race, let me see what else I got here for you. Yes, indeed. How would you like this? Magical brush. How would you like this brush? Brushed up against triggers. It took me the distance between Earth and the restaurant at the end of the universe. Of course, I had to put up with some Vogon poetry, but it was worth it. We just want to help you to relax. Relax your plastic bag head. I'm gonna call you bag head. Would you mind if I call you that? I didn't think you would. This look on you. I can see how it fuses right above your nose. So I get all around. It's quite peculiar indeed. And we just want to just brush like that. kind of feels like a monkey. He's got his butt up against your face like that. He just rubbing it. He just kind of, it feels kind of tickly. Yeah, it's kind of nice like that. Yeah. You ever have a marsupial rub itself up against your face? It's the relaxing kind of thing that you always dream about. Marsupial relaxation. Very, very marsupial relaxation. There's nothing quite like it. You ain't find that here on Earth, though. No, no. You gotta travel far out beyond the far reaches of space. Yeah, you sure do. Yeah. Would you like me to put one of these down for you? It'd be my pleasure. Now, how many of those do you think you would like? Okay. Alright, just a minute. You write down that you would like some of the brushing relaxation tingle. How many is that again? Okay. Alright. Okay. Alright. These next kind of triggers, you might remember these. Special kind of triggers. Take a look at these. Now, lots of clickety clackety sounds these make.
Crinkle,
would you like?
I know you're in there. Give yourself up.
Oh no, it's the bats. I gotta get out of here. You best get on your way. Don't mention that you saw me. Know what's good for you. I gotta get out of here as fast as I can.
I've got 5 minutes.
I'll get that order for you too, really quickly.
And take me back to Arkham.
It's time for Chris Crinkle to find a new location. I appreciate the business, but unfortunately, I'm gonna have to pack up now and go. It was a pleasure doing business with you. Until next time.
Crinkle, you've got nowhere to hide now.